This is All India Radio, Shillong, the Northeast News Bulletin, read by Miranda Blah. Prime Minister Narendra Modi spoke to Assam Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal and also reviewed the situation in the wake of flooding and landslides in some parts of the state. In a tweet, Modi assured all possible support from the centre to help those affected. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has sanctioned from Prime Minister's National Relief Fund an ex gratia of 2 lakh rupees each to the next of kin of persons who lost their lives due to floods in Assam. Assam Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal said that his government is making all-out efforts, including setting up of COVID-19 hospitals, to ensure best health care services for the patients. Sonowal visited COVID care centres at IIT Guwahati and Maniram Diwan Trade Centre in Guwahati to view the arrangements made for patients following a recent surge in the number of cases in Guwahati. Health and Family Welfare Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma, along with his junior minister Pijush Hazarika and officials of the health department, apprised Sonowal about the facilities available at the centres. 3 persons, including 2 BSF personnel, tested positive for COVID-19 in Meghalaya yesterday, taking the state's tally to 62, Chief Minister Conrad K. Sangma said. The 2 infected BSF personnel are from East Khasi Hills district, while the civilian is from Pribhoi, he said. With 3 new patients, the number of fresh cases reported in Meghalaya in the last 24 hours has risen to 6, a senior health official said. Of the 62 cases, 18 are active, while 43 persons have recovered and 1 patient has died, he said. In an effort to contain the spread of COVID-19, the magistrate of Ribhoi district under Section 144 CRPC read, together with Regulation 3 of the Meghalaya Epidemic Diseases, COVID-19 Regulations 2020, has promulgated curfew in the areas from Tandu Bridge via Bunihat to Jorabat, Pilangkata, Maikuli, Longkuli and Umtingar in Ribhoi district from 9 p.m. yesterday till further orders. This order is not applicable to security forces, medical teams on duty, emergency services and other essential services. 4 more persons have tested positive for COVID-19 in Nagaland, taking the state's tally to 539, Health Minister S. Pangnupom said. 3 new patients from quarantine centres in Mon district and 1 is from Peren district, he said. 31 people, however, 10 each from Peren, Kohima and Dimapur and 1 from Peck district have recovered from COVID-19, the minister added. Of the 539 cases, 311 are active, while 228 people have recovered, Pom said. The recovery rate has increased to 42.3% from 36.82% on Thursday, he added. In Tripura, 53 more COVID-19 patients have been discharged after recovery, counting a total of 1,146 recovered patients so far from the viral infection. The active positive cases in the state now stand at 248, while the total number of COVID-19 positive cases in the state has reached to 1,441 with the detection of 39 positive cases on Thursday. In Assam, the rapid antigen test is started in Guwahati city from yesterday. Talking to AIR, the Mission Director of National Health Mission, Assam Dr. Lakshmanan said that a person would get the result in 15 to 30 minutes. He said that if a person finds positive in a rapid antigen test, the person would be immediately sent to hospital. On the other hand, a negative report on this, the test would lead to an RT-PCR test, and in that case, the person is supposed to stay in home quarantine. A Sastra Seema Bal personnel has tested positive for COVID-19 in Sikkim, taking the state's tally 202, a health official report. The 33-year-old Jawan has tested positive for COVID-19 at the SSB camp in Yuksom in West Sikkim. Director General cum Secretary of the Health Department, Dr. Pempa T. Bhutia, said. The SSP personnel has entered Sikkim through the Meli checkpost on June 24th after undergoing 14-day quarantine in Siliguri in West Bengal. The Jawan was housed at the SSP quarantine centre in Yuksom along with 40 of his colleagues, Bhutia said. His sample was tested on the 2nd of this month, and after the reports turned positive for COVID-19, the SSB personnel was admitted to a hospital in Gangtok, he said. Arunachal Pradesh government has allowed all the places of worship outside the containment zones in the state to open with effect from the 1st of this month with restrictions. The health department has issued an order in this regard. The order issued by Health Secretary P. Pathibhan said all places of worship shall be regularly disinfected. And with that, we end the Northeast News Bulletin, which came to you from the Shillong station of All India Radio. Have a nice day.